Good evening, everyone. We are excited that all of you are here for our celebration of Jesus Christ's birth. Would you join me, please, here on Christmas Sanctuary that is on the screen? Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder.
And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
And now let's all stand and praise the Lord as we sing Hark, the Herald Angels Sing.
Sins will be exposed. For those who do what is right come to the light so others can see that they are doing what God wants. Let us pray. Glorious God, the light of the world, we admit that once we love the darkness rather than the light. We are so grateful for shining the light upon the truth upon us and bringing us to repentance and salvation. Now we ask for even more grace so others can see by our lives the light and the truth of Jesus Christ. Lord, I also pray that you are protecting those who serve in our country now are not as grateful as us three Marines appear to be with our loved ones for this Christmas and this New Year's. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
His government and his peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of heaven's armies will make this happen. And from Micah chapter 5 and verse 2, "But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, are only a small village among all the people of Judah. Yet a ruler of Israel will come from you, one whose goings forth are from the days of eternity." Amen. Stand with me as we sing together, "Angels We Have Heard on High."
taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All returned to their own ancestral towns to register for this census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, his wife, who was now obviously with child. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. Children's choir? You all are going to get a special blessing right now.
Thank you.
bring glory to God too. Amen. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy for all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, he has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger." Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth among those whom God is pleased with." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished. But Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them.
Thank you, Lady. What beautiful weather we have been having, huh? And it's just been so awesome. I walked out this morning and the birds were singing, and it just didn't even feel like December, really, but we'll take it. Definitely a blessing to be able to walk out without really even a jacket on. We ask that you would stand and please sing with us. Now, we heard the kids sing, and you guys, I know it's hard to follow that, but we got to try. So let's get on our feet.
you know, the silence of the night when our Savior was born. And I'm sure that there were those moments, and our Bible tells us that Mary stored up all these things and treasured them in her heart. But you know, there was also times on that night where the sky was alive and there was sound and excitement. And you know, when the shepherds appeared to the angels, they were terrified. I think we tend to think of the angels as Tinkerbell. They definitely were not. They were warriors of God and brilliant messengers of light. And when they appeared to the shepherds were terrified. And the angels, of course, gave them the best news that has ever been given. This song wakes it up a little bit more. And I know that a lot of you will be familiar with it, so please stay with it.
Thank you.
Abbe Kendall, five little fingers.
Finally able to land.
and it was the middle of the afternoon. And the tongues went off, and just me and one other guy were the only ones able to go on the scene. And they've been head on a collision. And the mother and the daughter were injured worse. The other fireman with me, he took care of the traffic, and I went to try to encourage and see what I could do with the people in the cars, waiting on other help to come. And as I got up to the car, I found yours. Got the mom out okay. She was bleeding, but she was all right. But the daughter in the passenger seat in the front end of the car, the passenger door then knocked off and flew off. Front end of the car was just smashed right up against her, so that her legs were pinned under metal, and she was awake and alert, and she was bleeding here and there, cuts from the windshield, and of course I'm trying to keep her calm. I was praying with her. You know, she didn't say a thing about, didn't complain a bit about me praying with her. The rest of the guys finally arrived on the scene and got the jaws of life and was able to get that metal off of her legs, and we got her out of there. And I want to tell you, Laura was one happy person. That's happy. Others who may be happy might be those who, after minutes in a burning building, are finally rescued. We thrill when we read of the rescue of miners, or of mountain climbers, or of a child who has fallen deep into a well. What irony when a soldier risks his life to save a buddy, only to have his buddy refuse to help and say, "Take care of yourself, save yourself. I'll be all right. I can get myself out of this." And then he dies. The greatest rescue operation of all time began on the first Christmas day. Yet, most people refuse to be rescued. We're confident that we can solve our own problems. We deny that we are in danger. But man's danger is fantastically great. There are all those ordinary dangers of sickness, accident, war, poverty, and death. Then there are the dangers that those people have who have been striving for the wrong goals in life. Then there are the dangers of misplaced self-confidence and the consequences that follow. Then there are the dangers that those have who are unaware of the spiritual realm around us all the time. But the biggest danger of all is the lack of realization that man is destined to an eternal dwelling, either in unspeakable sorrow or unspeakable joy. In fact, man's danger was so great that the infinite God had to become man in order to rescue man. No one else could do it. God became man in the person of the baby Jesus. That is why Christmas is so important. You see, every man has sinned. Now, sin is not some minor weakness that can be cured by a few good intentions, or a few good works, or even a few prayers and other religious activities. No, our sin was a rebellion against God, which made us enemies of God. The God who created us, gave us life. Our sin is a selling of ourselves to the devil, a total pollution of our wills and minds and souls. Our sin has made us self-centered slaves to our own desire. The only rescue from this pit of degradation is by someone taking the punishment due us, and also having the power to clean up our innermost being. And this is exactly what Jesus Christ did. Since he is the sinless Son of God, he could bear the infinite anger of God against all sin. And he sends his Spirit into our lives so that we who come to him can be cleansed from every impurity. He truly makes us new creatures. Let's look at Romans chapter 5 and verse 8. Maybe I'll just go to the Bible here. Romans 5. There it is. Yet the proof of God's amazing love is this. Pay attention to what the scriptures say. The proof of God's amazing love is this, that it was while we were sinners that Christ died for us. While we were sinners, he came after us. It wasn't because we were seeking him out or because we asked for help. The first move was God's. He came after us. Thank you. Romans chapter 8, verses 1 and 2. No condemnation now hangs over the head of those who are in Christ Jesus. Though we deserve it, there is none if we are in Christ Jesus. For the new spiritual principle of life in Christ lifts me out of the old vicious circle of sin and death, gives us power to get out of that vicious circle of sin and death. Thank you, Jesus. He's rescuing us. But this rescue must be accepted. We must confess our sin. We must ask God's forgiveness. He is a perfect gentleman and will not force his way into anyone's life. We must accept the only way of salvation. There is only one, and that is by having faith in Jesus Christ. 1 John 1:9. If we freely admit that we have sinned, we find God utterly reliable and straightforward. Freely admit. And he forgives us. If we will do that, then he forgives us our sins and makes us thoroughly clean. I like what other scriptures say, that our sins are separated from us as far as the east is from the west. Hallelujah. Amen. He cleanses us from all that is evil, from the inside out. Thank you, Lord. Does God love you? John 3:16. Most well-known scripture in the Bible. For God so loved the world. That means he loves you and he loves me. We remember that in the context of Christmas, church. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Let heaven as God, the glories of heaven with the angels worship. and serving him constantly, praising him. And he left all of that to come down here. So that we who believe in him shall not be lost. God does not want you to be lost. He does not want anyone to be lost. He wants us to have eternal life. What a wonderful salvation from a horrible condition. Now that's why this is a Merry Christmas. Would you bow your head with me a moment? God has spoken to us by his word through one of these preachers. And when God speaks, my mom thought it's always good to respond when someone speaks to you. But when God speaks, and he's speaking to you right now, then we should respond. You should respond. First, for those who have made Jesus their Lord and Savior and are not in the same relationship with him that they once were, if that's you, would you ask him to forgive you? Right where you are, heads bowed and eyes closed. Just whisper unto him right where you are that you're sorry and you're asking him again to come in and fill you up. Fill you with life. Separate you from evil. Be your Lord again. And if you've never confessed your sins to him, if you've never trusted Jesus' death on the cross as payment for your sins, if you've never invited God, Jesus Christ, into your heart, then right where you are, right now, you can change your destination, the destination for your eternity. Let him know that you're sorry. Ask him to forgive you. Invite him into your heart and your life, and promise with his help that you'll serve him from today forward throughout eternity with all that you have and all that you are. And that new life, even now, will be pouring into you, cleansing you, and starting that work of making you just like Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Heads bowed and eyes closed. There's still a whole lot of people out there in this community and in this world, in your families, in your neighborhood, on your job, at the stores you shop at, who do not know Jesus. They are lost. They are headed for an eternity of tremendous sorrow. If they don't hear and receive Jesus, who's going to tell them? Today, the Lord is asking us to tell them to not be fearful, but to be care about them enough to share Jesus when we get those opportunities. God is asking you tonight, right now, if he makes it obvious to you that he wants you to tell someone about Jesus, are you willing to do that? If he helps you, if so, just raise your hand to him now, and I believe he'll pour his spirit into you to help you do that. Father, so we ask that in Jesus' name. Pour your spirit in new ways to give boldness and a love for the lost unto those who are desiring it right now. And we thank you, Father, for your work in this service. Through Jesus Christ. And the believers said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We're going to begin our candle lighting ceremony now. If there are some of you that do not have candles, just raise your hand and someone will get you some candles.
I'm going to light my candle from the Christ candle. That's the only place to get the real light, true light. And then I'm going to pass his light to the ushers. And then they're going to pass his light to you. And then even though we're going to extinguish them later, will you carry that light up from here? And just a reminder, if your candle is lit, you do not dip. So only when your candle is unlit do you dip to light off another candle. And then while we're doing this, how about everyone stand? And we'll sing Silent Night again. Let's together pray the Christmas prayer. It's on the screen before us. Oh God,
who has made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of the true light, grant, we beseech thee, that as we have known on earth the mysteries of that light, we may also come to the fullness of its joys in heaven. Through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord.
Extinguish your candles. Bow your heads with me for closing prayer. Father, thank you for the life that you've given us. We pray that we might use it to bring glory to your name, to lift you high. For you are such a glorious God. Thank you for putting Christmas on the calendar, Father, to remind us that you left heaven to come here to rescue us. And we are grateful. And that's why we gather here this night, to worship you. And we will keep Jesus in the center of Christmas. Please join me in praying as our Lord taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven.